In 1945, a clever and somewhat successful escape took place just ahead at the dock area. Inmate number 250, John Knight Giles, sent here after escaping from another prison, somehow landed a premier job as a dock worker handling army uniforms, which continued to be laundered here. Giles had spent years assembling and successfully hiding a full staff sergeant uniform and secretly slipped off his prison-issue coveralls, which concealed his clever disguise, then casually strolled in full uniform onto a departing army vessel, which docked at the island daily. Giles actually made it off the island before his absence was noted after a routine headcount. Prison guards raced by patrol boat to the steamer's next port of call, Fort McDowell on nearby Angel Island, where Staff Sergeant Giles was promptly reapprehended and summarily stripped of his short-lived military rank. Less than a year after Giles' creative escape attempt failed, six other desperate convicts would carry out another dramatic attempt in 1946. Inmate number 415, Bernard Coy, after starving himself down to skin and bones, and with the aid of a crude bar spreader, slipped through a section of bars within the cell house, surprised armed officer Bill Miller, and proceeded to punch him unconscious. Coy now had Miller, his keys, rifle, and a .45 caliber automatic handgun, and a bitter hatred of authority. A siege of the cell house was on, one that would last nearly 3 days before the military was called in to help. Grenades were dropped through the rooftop, and the convicts fired back from within, in what became widely known as the Battle of Alcatraz. When the dust settled and the cell house was retaken by authority, two guards, including Miller, and three instigators were dead. The two others who took part would be executed at nearby San Quentin State Prison just 6 months later. It would be years before any others would even try. Although one of the most successful virtual escapes from Alcatraz had already quietly occurred, just along the cell house, along the steep embankments, we see facing the beautiful Golden Gate. Elliot Mishner found some keys at the bottom of the stairs, returning from his industry's job, and after quickly swooping them up, realized that it might be a setup and turned them into the guard at the top. As a reward for his honesty, the warden offered Mishner the opportunity to start a garden outside the prison walls, which the administration had been planning to create.